Authorities pointing to what they call evidence of hate.
The shooter had authored several manifestos. Plainly put, this shooting was racially motivated and he hated black people.
A 21-year-old man gunned down and killed three black Americans at a Jacksonville, Florida Dollar General store. This happened on Saturday in what authorities are describing as a racially motivated hate crime. The shooter, who the sheriff's office said posted racial writings and even had three separate manifestos, killed himself after the shooting. And here's more from the sheriff's press conference with more details about how the shooting took place.
I want to begin by honoring the three precious lives that were lost yesterday. Angela Michelle Carr, 52 years old. Anolt Joseph, or AJ Laguerre Jr., 19 years old. And Gerald Deshaun Gallion, 29 years old.
Authorities say they were senselessly gunned down because they were black. The alleged gunman identified as 21-year-old Ryan Christopher Palmeter. Authorities saying that before the shooting, Palmeter was spotted at a historically black university. An Edward Waters University security guard engaging and forcing the alleged shooter to drive away.
It looks to me that he went there to change into whatever he needed to change into. He had an opportunity to do violence in EWU. He did not.
In fact, a spokesperson with the university said the following. A spokesperson from Edward Waters University said the man was spotted on campus by a security guard shortly before the shooting and asked to leave when he refused to identify himself. He was seen putting on his bullet-resistant vest and mask before he drove away. Then the gunman made his way to the Dollar General store where the mass shooting took place. I just want to warn you, the next video might be difficult for some to view. With that warning, let's take a look.
The sheriff says the 11-minute rampage began Saturday afternoon. At 1:08, surveillance video outside the store captures the shooter without warning, raising his weapon and firing 11 rounds.
Shooting into a black Kia and murders the first victim, Ms. Angela Carr.
He then walked inside, gun drawn, wearing a tactical vest.
The suspect enters the Dollar General store and engages the second victim, a young 19-year-old victim, Anolt Laguerre.
One of his guns with a white swastika painted on it. Authorities say minutes later, Gerald Gallion entered the store with his girlfriend. The gunman killing Gallion and missing his girlfriend. At 1:18, 10 minutes into the shooting, the gunman allegedly texts his father telling his dad to check his computer.
Father enters the room and finds a last will and testament of the suspect along with a suicide note on his laptop.
By 1:53, the suspect's family called to alert the Clay County Sheriff's Office. But by that time, the rampage was over. The shooter dying by suicide as officers arrived on scene.
So just to provide a few more details, he had two firearms on him, including an AR-15 and a Glock handgun. He also, as I mentioned earlier, left behind three manifestos. Officials say there were writings to his family, federal law enforcement, and at least one media outlet. At least one of the guns had swastikas painted on it. Sheriff T.K. Waters, who you just heard from in that video, said that the shooter made clear in his writings that he hated black people. And we do have an image of the weapon that has the swastika signs on it, providing further evidence that this was a hatefully motivated crime.
Yeah, there's no question about that. Okay, two minor issues and then two major issues. The minor issues are, hey, look, a security guard worked in that case, at least at the university before he went to the dollar store. And we, that's not a thing that supports our position overall, but I wanted to note it in this case because that's a fact and that happened, okay? So number two is in the stories that I read, they keep talking about, oh, well, the gun was legal. Well, who cares? I don't understand why that, like, it's the easiest thing in the world to get a gun in this country. You can just walk in and go, I exist. And they'll give you the Wagner group and have you march to Moscow if you like. You can get an army of, like a flotilla of goddamn guns with no problem at all. So what difference does it make if it's legal?
Yeah,
or illegal?
And look, it does depend on which state you're in. But remember, we're talking about the state of Florida, which has even more lax gun laws. It's much more easier to purchase guns in states like Texas and Florida.
In Florida, you could walk in and say, I'm a psychotic, syphilitic clown, and they'll give you every weapon that you want, right? So that's gonna get to the major issue, but I don't care that it was legal, okay? That's actually part of the problem. So obviously, one of the major issues is guns. That's the one thing that connects all these killings is AR-15s. So this guy is, are there weirdo Nazi racist in the country? Unfortunately, far too many. Mm-hmm. The problem, so that exists in other countries as well, except the other countries don't go around going, here, have an automatic weapon, murder anyone you like, okay? Yeah, if we allow everyone to have weapons, the Nazis are gonna have the weapons, the deeply racist guys who write manifestos are gonna have the weapons, and they're gonna use it to murder people of color, Jews, et cetera, et cetera. Of course, we should stop giving guns to everyone, everyone. Okay, this guy was had a mental health lockdown order on him in 2017. Doesn't matter, here's a gun, here's all the guns you want. Doesn't matter, nothing matters. You're a Nazi, it doesn't matter, have a gun. We're not gonna check, we're not gonna check anything, okay?
Yeah, so let me jump in on that because I think that there are some caveats to that point that are important to share with the audience. So he did get in trouble with the law on domestic violence issues. For instance, he had been involved in a 2016 domestic violence incident that did not lead to an arrest and was involuntarily committed for a 72-hour mental health examination the following year. Now, he used two guns, as I mentioned earlier, a Glock handgun and an AR-15 semi-automatic rifle. Sheriff T.K. Waters said they were purchased legally earlier this year, to Cenk's point earlier in the story. Now, he was a minor in both those instances, and when you're a minor, your records are sealed, right? So if you're an adult and you had a mandatory 72-hour hold, let's say you live in a state that has red flag laws, that could be flagged and that could prevent an individual from purchasing a gun. But that wouldn't apply in this particular context because of the fact that he was a minor, and I do not believe that Florida is a red state law.
So Anna, you're making perfectly good-
Red flag law.
Yeah, you're making perfectly good points, except I don't care about any of that. The reason is I would have 1,000 times stricter laws. You were mentally incapacitated a little while earlier, but not now. So okay, that doesn't qualify under the incredibly weak laws we're proposing and have no chance of passing. Okay, so look, no one should have an AR-15. No one should have these assault weapons at all. You don't need them for hunting, and you know it. If you need it for hunting, you're a loser, a total incompetent loser who's gonna butcher half the woods when you go in there. Okay, the only reason you use it for is mass murder and shooting Bud Light. So I don't care about you shooting Bud Light enough to say, oh, that's such an important right. Let's just murder our kids and let people murder everyone because Kid Rock wants to shoot at Bud Light with an AR-15. Okay, now look, the racial issue here is obvious, but that one is harder. What are you gonna do? Yes, some people in this country, let's keep it real, mainly right-wing media and politicians, drive hatred and hatred and hatred and hatred, right? And then some people back down that hatred. But what are we gonna do? Shut them down? Well, we can't. There's freedom of speech in this country. So look, talk to your family members. Make sure that they don't get into this cult. Because the problem is a cult, and one of the other, the Buffalo shooter, now has turned around in court and said he regrets it. He also was totally 100% racial, went to go shoot black people, totally admits it, etc. Had a manifesto, etc. Now he's like, I read this stuff online. I can't believe I did it. I can't believe I believed the stuff I read online.
Well, you did it, and it was, look, I watched, unfortunately, I watched the live stream of that shooting.
Mm-hmm.
No, I'm sorry. You don't read propaganda online and feel so inspired by it that you gun down innocent people in a racially motivated hate crime. Anyway, spare me the tears. And of course, he's working on his defense.
Of course, all that is absolutely right.
But there is, look, I want to say something. Look, you make some legitimate points when it comes to the necessity of stricter gun regulations. As I've said before on the show, I am not a proponent of banning guns. I do believe in the Second Amendment. However, I do think that it's far too easy for individuals who shouldn't have a weapon to legally purchase these weapons. That said, the other half of this, and I'm not trying to make a right-wing talking point that deflects from the need for gun control, but I do think it is legitimate to bring up the very real issue of mental health problems that go undiagnosed and untreated in this country. And I mean, look at the demographic that we constantly deal with in regard to these mass shootings. They're typically young men. And young men right now in the country are in fact experiencing a pretty significant crisis, a crisis involving depression, a crisis involving loneliness. Suicide rates are much higher among young men versus women. All of these issues are serious issues that need to be addressed adequately, and none of these issues are being addressed adequately.
100%. So let me clarify it this way. Look, this is a toxic stew here. You've got mental health problems plus propaganda plus assault weapons equals massacres. No question about it. That's exactly what's happened every time. So now the question is, what can you do about those three factors? Unfortunately, even the hateful propaganda is the one that is most protected by our Constitution and the hardest one to tackle. Whereas mental health is not a constitutional issue at all, and we could do something about it. And every Republican liar after one of these shootings, and I mean the politicians in this case, go out and go, I didn't have mental health, not the guns, I love my guns. I don't care if they murder your kids with them, I love my guns, right? But mental health, and then they go for a vote, and this is the part that's never covered by mainstream media. They go to vote on mental health and they all vote no.
The last time there was a vote on funding, appropriating the necessary resources for mental health in America, only one Republican lawmaker voted in favor of those appropriations.
Yeah, they're liars,
so
grotesque liars.
They gotta put their money where their mouth is, and it's just abundantly clear to me and anyone else paying attention that they use the mental health talking point specifically to deflect from having to discuss, in my opinion, necessary gun reform legislation, including provisions in legislation that the vast majority of Americans, including Republicans, including gun owners, are in favor of.
Yes, and by the way, it is perfectly constitutional to do a universal background check, and anywhere from 88 to 97% of Americans, including the overwhelming majority of NRA members, gun owners, say we should do universal background checks, but we don't have them because the Republicans are bribed by the NRA. And so you could at least do that. That is so tiny. But assault weapons is a real one. And that pulls around two-thirds. Two-thirds of the country says ban assault weapons. There's no constitutional problem with that. But no, corruption. So we can't do that either. I would ban assault weapons in a second. And I would do a lot more mental health counseling. But the Republicans say no to both. So you're gonna have endless massacres brought to you by the Republican Party.
Now, during a vigil, Governor Ron DeSantis was addressing people at the vigil, just talking about how horrendous this racially motivated hate crime was, and he ended up getting booed. We're gonna show you that video in our members only section of the show. If you're not a member, you can become one by going to tyt.com/join, or you can click on that join button if you're watching us on YouTube. But you gotta check out that video. Maybe we'll have a longer discussion about that as well.
Yeah, we will, because I wanna see, talk about whether it's fair or not, whether you let him speak, don't let him speak in a contest like that. But looking forward to seeing the members there. You could hit the join button below the video on YouTube to join as well.
If you enjoy this video, that's because of our members. They make us independent, they make us strong, and they make us honest. Become a member today by hitting the join button below.